right, so here he is, one of the best flyweights on planet Earth at present, fighting out of Baghdad, Iraq, Amir Albazi. Came to the UFC with heightened expectations. Largely, he has lived up to all of that. He has never been finished as a mixed martial arts pro, and many believe if he can get the job done here tonight, with style points or otherwise, he could be next to challenge for the undisputed UFC flyweight championship of the world. Amir Albazi has arrived. Well, if you want to tell me that this particular fighter is on the wrong end of the power equation, I'll give you that. But few guys can match his speed and his footwork. Prevailing wisdom is he'll try to fight on the outside tonight, stick and move a little bit. Exceptionally quick on his feet, sets up angles beautifully, manages distance as good as anybody on the roster, knows how to set up his attacks, knows how to stay in his opponent's range. Figures to be a big part of the strategy tonight, given the power that's coming back. So here's the former UFC flyweight champion, the assassin baby, Brandon Moreno, first Mexican-born UFC champion, and remarkably made his pro debut all the way back in 2011 in Tijuana when he was 17 years of age.
I mean, a baby. The guy was a baby, and still today, proven to be one of the best fighters in the world. He has a tremendous skill set, great grappling, great wrestling, great boxing, unbelievable cardio, and that Mexican spirit, that fighting spirit that carries him through the tough times. I will stand out here on a limb and tell you, I did not expect this from Brandon Moreno.
Yeah.
But to see him overachieve has truly been something special. Let's see if he gets the job done tonight.
And of course, as many of you know, he is now training in the United States of America, and that, of course, has led to some big results of late. Huge spot for the assassin baby, Brandon Moreno, here tonight. Kill the tape for this flyweight fight. All right, now for the particulars, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It's time! 5 rounds in the UFC flyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Amir the Prince Albazi! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, presenting the former UFC flyweight champion of the world, Brandon the Assassin Baby!
Herb Dean is your referee. Right, he's the third man in the octagon tonight. Good. All right, early round action here as we get a look at the former UFC flyweight champion, the assassin baby, Brandon Moreno. His evolution has been marked. It has been incredible. It has been off the charts when you think about his time on The Ultimate Fighter to his time as UFC flyweight champion. The jab, the chokes, the finishing instincts. One of the best pound-for-pound fighters in the game, and ready to get back to it as he tries to ascend back to championship level status. Beautiful technique on the straight right hand. All right, so we'll see if Brandon Moreno can get off to a good start tonight. He is a 5-tool player, but the jab would appear to be his weapon of choice here in the early game.
And honestly, John, he's developed it even further as he has gone to Missouri to train. The guy is getting better. He does a good job of finding his range. He shortened his stance a little bit, so he's not so much in a boxing stance, but he is using that to defend leg kicks more effectively, but also still have the ability to go find that jab.
Oh, and a switch kick to the body for good measure. Nice job there by Albazi. Straight right is there. Gets caught by that straight punch. You gotta do better than that defensively.
Let's go. I need you to be first now.
Oh, man.
minutes and counting to go here in round one. Unable to connect with the right hand there. Going to the leg kick now, and it's there. Nice job by Amir Albazi. Lands the overhand right.
Oh, big stick up top. That's another one. He's got to start kicking. Kicking the body, kicking the head. He's just got to start kicking.
Well, the left hook has been there at times, not that time. Shows him the left and then follows it up with a right. Nice 1-2 punch there by Albazi.
Oh, big punch land.
And now the jab gets through. 2 minutes to go. Big power shot there. Albazi's cut above the eye, and that blood figures to start to trickle down. Could compromise his vision here moving forward. Kick to the body now. That one won't land.
Big shot lands to both guys.
Amir Albazi gets hit with that hook shot there. He's got to be careful to not allow the offense to follow up here.
Nice leg kick.
Well, you can feel that bruise octagon side after the swing and a miss by Albazi. Quick jab. Punches and bunches as he lands another combination there. Really doing a nice job stringing the shots together.
He's doing a great job of stringing the shots together and also just mixing up the target and the attacks. Great job finding different places for his strikes to land.
Effective lead right hand there by Brandon Moreno. Seconds to go. Fighter lands a jab. Ooh, he lands a kick to the leg. Trying to get the head kick home, and now his opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize it. It's high, and now he's got hurt bad.
All right, so that round is in the books. Amir Albazi's bleeding from the forehead a little bit, so we'll keep an eye on that as the fight continues. Hopefully the cut man can do his work and get it under control so it doesn't bleed down into the fighter's eyes. Well, if you like blood, maybe this is the fight for you, because blood has really become a factor, and it's a cut that appears to be right above his eye.
That's one of the worst spots for you to get a cut, because then the blood starts to come down and it goes into the eye. It's difficult already to see, but when you got one of the best mixed martial artists in the world targeting it, it becomes impossible.
They call that the trickle-down effect.
Ready.
That's what that is?
That's right.
Ready.
Second round underway. All right, next round is now underway. I thought there was pretty good back and forth action in the previous fight.
Yes, it wasn't a firefight. It wasn't two guys throwing the kitchen sink at each other. But you did see times when it came together and you saw the skill level of these two fighters. Another punch lands for this fighter.
Leg kick lands. Nice jab by Brandon Moreno. High guard, and he gets that thing to the target quick.
Gets to the target quick, and you can see the assassin baby start to really feel himself right now. He has found his flow, he's in his groove, and like I said, that jab is what starts everything coming from the fighter from Mexico.
Oh, the roundhouse kick lands. Nice defense there. Huge block.
Oh, good body kick landed there. When both are prepared, these are the types of fights that we expect.
Well, he's always working off of that jab. Nice jab there by the assassin baby, Brandon Moreno.
All right, well, that blow is buffeting from that cut with each strike landed, and he continues to effectively target that area.
You know, we are talking about a guy with a super high fight IQ. So when you give him that, that crimson red is nothing more than something that inspires him to continue doing what he's doing. So you have got to change something. You got to get your head moving so you're not taking too much damage to that cut.
This pace is just absurd, and he has kept it up throughout the fight. Shades of Max Holloway against Calvin Kattar, punches and punches.
I mean, being there, watching Max Holloway do what he did was super impressive. So to even list his performance alongside that tells you how this guy is fighting tonight.
Under 3 minutes to go in round two. Moreno gets tagged by that stiff jab.
Punches in combination really dictate the pace to his opponent.
Let me see that hook now.
Well, this is kind of crazy the way this is transpiring. This jiu-jitsu fighter looks like a professional boxer here tonight. He told us about his evolution. He has absolutely taken it to the next level.
He has taken it to the next level, J.A. I mean, this guy is so comfortable in the striking. Before in his career, early, he looked a little bit lost. He looked like he was desperate to get takedowns. Now, he seems to be comfortable everywhere. So the work that they are putting in is truly paying dividends.
Oh, well-timed overhand there by Brandon Moreno.
When he gets close and he throws, he lands.
Moreno's nose is bleeding now. Yes, looks as though he got cut by one of those offerings from his opponent. Here, Albazi gets tagged by that straight punch. Nice land for the offense there.
What a beautiful strike lands again. Great job.
Well, you know this is the hurt business, and both guys are compromised at this stage of the fight.
Yeah, both guys are compromised. Both guys have been beat up. Both guys have done a great job of landing, recognizing what they wanted to get done, and then showing. This is a very evenly matched fight.
Well, perhaps it's a high fight IQ, perhaps it's obvious, but he is attacking that cut that is getting deeper by the minute.
And it seems like the right decision, because you can see his opponent starting to paw at it. You can see it starting to take an effect. It's messing with him mentally. For him, he's got to continue to attack that area and hope that it just keeps getting worse and worse.
Oh, misses with the jab. Seems as though his sole focus is attacking that cut, and man, it's getting bad now. A lot of blood flowing.
Yeah, as it should be. Now, he should be focused on getting to that cut, making his opponent pay. He did the work. He opened up the cut. Now it's on him to continue on the path and make the ringside position, come in here and try to stop this fight. Punch got blocked there.
10 minutes in the can.
All right, so the round is over, and you see the cut man not wasting any time as the fighter makes his way back to the stool. The cut man will try to shut that cut on the bridge of his nose and prevent it from becoming a factor here moving forward. All right, so now we have some real adversity. There's a cut on the nose. Hard to know if that's impacting the breathing, but some definite damage in that previous round.
Yeah, some real damage. And now when you get a cut like that, that is in a bad spot. Is every time you get hit on the nose, it's so jarring. And then the blood starts to go down into the mouth. He's got an uphill battle ahead of him.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Third round underway. All right, pretty good back and forth action in the previous two rounds. Your expectations here as this next round gets underway?
I expect the action to really pick up now. These guys have to lay it on the line as we start to approach.
Oh, a huge strike lands there, DC.
He landed that massive shot. Now he needs to try to find the next shot, the follow-up shot, that will finish the fight.
Here we go. Here, Albazi gets hit with that overhand, flush to the head. Oh, shot to the body connects there. He hasn't really thrown too many body strikes in this fight, but now, as this fight goes on, he is not discriminating, working the body, and those shots are going to count. And both fighters exchange in the pocket. Moreno gets hit with a kick here. That one landed flush. Let's see if he can make some adjustments.
Nice straight punch.
Watching the referee right then and there has called a stop to the action. Looks like he's going to call on the doctor to look at the cut, and it is a pretty significant one, DC.
Well, he's bleeding a lot, and the blood is going into his eyes. It's very difficult for him to see right now.
Well, if you like blood, this is the fight for you. Doesn't appear to be affecting his vision too badly right now. Looks as though he's going to let him play.
Wow, he allows him to continue. Very surprising.
Fans are with it. All right, so the ref will get the action back underway after that brief health and safety check. And to no one's surprise, the fans support the decision for the action to continue.
Absolutely. I mean, this official decided we can go. Even though at times the fighter may question whether or not he can do it, you have very smart ringside officials that make a determination. The determination is get your butt out of there and fight. Let's see what happens.
And we have a very smart fighter who is going to have to start protecting that injury to prevent it from getting any worse. Oh, Albazi's really targeting that cut right now, and why not? He has opened up his opponent. Might as well continue to attack that particular area.
Good work, guys. Put your hands up higher. Come on.
3 minutes now to go in this one. Oh, he's landed a high number of total strikes here in the latter stages of this fight. He's really picked up the pace and landing far more strikes than he did in previous rounds.
Nice block. Fighter lands a nasty kick.
Both fighters starting to open up a little bit. Here, Albazi's cut is getting worse here. Man, is that bleeding. Straight right hand now, just misses. Oh, effective use of the jab by Amir Albazi. With 2 minutes and change to go in round three. Right on the button.
I mean, is this thing on repeat? How many times can you say punch to the head?
Well, he continues to stay busy, and he continues to land with volume punches.
I mean, volume, but he's not wasting anything. He's so accurate out there.
Nice straight right lands. Side kick lands for him there, champ.
A lot of times, that is used to manage speed.
Albazi's body getting all sorts of bruised up on that right side now. Lands a strike there.
Massive body kick land.
Missed with that right hand.
Short time now in the round.
Strikes in this round and really hasn't let up when it comes to his aggressiveness. The striking has been on point every step of the way. Careful to not gas out, but you gotta like the output here down the stretch. Back and forth we go. It takes two to tango, and man, have these two individuals tangoed tonight. I might run it back at some point, no matter how this one ends.
It's one of those fights where when you look at these two and the damage on their faces, the work that they have both put in, you realize and you appreciate what these fighters do inside the octagon. They're both hurt. They're both beat up. And both of these guys have shown a tremendous amount of resilience to put themselves in position to win this fight.
Oh, that's gonna be it. Oh, submission defense on full display there.
He said that he was very aware of what this guy brought to the octagon, and it showed in that defense.
Well, what a war of attrition this fight has been. Both fighters dealing with cuts, critical damage in the facial area. Something's got to give at some point.
Yeah, these are the types of fights that we love. These guys are leaking everywhere. They're both trying to finish this fight. They're very evenly matched, and you could see it in the competition, but you can also see it in the damage that they're both showing.
Well, that was a damaging 5 minutes. We'll see how he can recover over this 60 seconds. We'll show you some replays now from that previous round.
He was on the receiving end of some big blows, and he wasn't moving his head well. His head was on the center line. He was a stationary target, and his opponent opened up a nasty cut on him. He has got to move his head to limit the damage that he's taking.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, here's round four, fight scheduled for five-minute rounds. Well, not only has he stayed aggressive as he was in the previous round, landing a high volume of strikes, but he's also been efficient, not just with his strikes, but also with his body movement. Complete performance out of this fighter here tonight. Both fighters throwing heat now. Albazi's nose is just donating blood by the second here. I'm not so sure that nose isn't broken, DC.
Kick lands for this guy.
He's had a huge strike right there. I'm not sure how many more of these his opponent can take.
Massive shot that he landed. Great job.
Oh! Moreno's head kick looked like that one was blocked. All right, so now we start to see some redness underneath the elbow. You got to think he's going to continue to attack the body with all of his strikes.
Well, his opponent has not done anything to deter him. He should keep doing this, keep going to the well until his opponent finds an answer, because right now, he seems lost to it.
Rip the body there. Amir Albazi's cut on his forehead is so bad at this point that maybe the doctor is going to come in here and take a look at it. He might even stop this fight. Hook to the head there by Brandon Moreno. Oh, man, that cut not in a good place, and it's not getting any better.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick. That knee hurt him.
Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. Went for the inside leg kick. Well, the crowd continues to react with every pass and land, but if you're the referee or even the corner, somebody's got to get involved with
this. Somebody's got to do something. It's getting very uncomfortable to watch this. And as the crowd gets excited, there's also a little bit of that. I don't want to see any more going on in their reactions.
Moreno gets tagged with a kick now. Let's see if he can wrap. Watch, the referee has called for the ringside position. Perhaps enough damage now to stop the fight.
Yeah, it's too much. It's too much. It's over. Stop the fight.
Well, Doctor not here to make friends. To that end, that is the end of the fight. It was a great fight as long as it lasted, but I'm not sure the doctor had any other choice.
Doctor didn't have a choice. He had to take a look, and rightfully so. He got beat up, got cut, fight got stopped.
The official decision is in. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the doctor has called a stop to this fight, declaring the winner by TKO, Brandon the Assassin Baby Moreno!
All right, perhaps time for, at the very least, another stripe on the belt. The Brazilian jiu-jitsu practitioner gets it done and is able to do so by submission.
This guy is so skilled, though, John. Like, I don't know. He's probably max.